Hey guys, so today I have my May favorites for you. This is my last favorites before baby comes for sure, because I will be 39 weeks pregnant by the time you watch this. So yeah, if you watched my last pregnancy vlog, then you know how I feel. But I'm still super congested, but I feel a little bit better. But yeah, contractions have been crazy, and I just hope she comes soon. So, but not tomorrow, because tomorrow is our fourth anniversary on June 4th. It's our fourth anniversary, and might be selfish, but we don't want to share our anniversary with her birthday. So, you know, so if she comes tomorrow, it won't be anything I did to cause myself to go into labor, because I'm really trying not to today. Anyways, let's just jump right in. So first of all, I've been loving my Makeup Geek shadows. I've just been using them pretty much nonstop. I'll either do just like creme brulee by itself in the crease for something easy, and then smudge a little of that, or latte under the lower lash line. Today I have Shimma Shimma on the inner corner, and then I used Peach Smoothie, a little bit of Cupcake, and then a little bit of Latte on the crease, and they just blend really nicely. I just love them. Those four or five or six right there are definitely ones that you should try if you want to get some Makeup Geek shadows. I just absolutely love them. That one's a good one too. My mind is blanking. Oh, Vanilla Bean. That's a good just all over lid color. But I also love Mango Tango. I believe that is Burlesque. But if you want some really great everyday colors, some great ones to start with would be these. Again, that's I'll list them down below. But sorry about my voice. Creme Brulee, Peach Smoothie, Latte, Cupcake, Shimma Shimma was a great highlight. So yeah, those are just some really great ones. And I've also been loving my MAC Pro shaping powder in Emphasize. I didn't use it today, which I totally forgot to add a highlight. Aww. Man, I'm gonna have to. It has a little bit of shimmer in it. Oh, and a little speck there too. Meh. It's not a ton of a highlight, but yeah. So I've been loving my MAC Pro shaving powder as well. And yeah, just absolutely love those. Pardon my messy palette, but yeah. Love, love, love. So yes. And then I just have a brush. This is the Sedona Lace EB13. It's the only crease brush I used today. I just did one shadow, then the next one, then the next one. And it's just really easy. It's a really great fluffy blending brush. I do have two of these, which I'm glad I do now, but I had accidentally got the second one because at first I just didn't really love it. I was just kind of meh, I don't know. But now I've been using it all the time. And I love it. It's pretty much the only crease brush I've been using, and I've been really lazy too. Like most days, I've just been doing the one color in my crease when I don't feel that great, but I would just want something there so I look somewhat presentable. Yeah, so that's just a really great crease brush. And I always have a Sedona Lace link down below. They are a bit more affordable than like Sigma and stuff. They have discounts all the time. They'll have like 20% off, and then you can always find a $5 off discount code on top of that. Their shipping is really cheap. So yeah, I do like Sedona Lace a lot. And then mascara. I'm really kind of bummed that I love this so much right now because it's almost gone. And that always happens. That's the L'Oreal Voluminous Butterfly Intensa waterproof mascara. It always happens that way. I'll be using mascara for like 3-4 months and then I'll start to just absolutely love it when it's like almost dried out, because that's when it works the best. And yeah, so now that I love it, it's almost gone. But yeah, anyways, but that is really good mascara. I like how the wand is really great for giving length on my puny little lashes. So yeah, I have been enjoying that. But again, it's a little sad because it's almost gone. And then I have a couple blushes. I'm actually not wearing any of these today. I'm wearing Tarte Prim. But last few days I wore my Milani Baked Blush in Delizioso Pink. It's a matte blush. And this is obviously drugstore, super affordable. It's like $5-6. These, I love how buildable this is. I used my Sigma F40 and like you could put it on really light and sheer, or you can build it up gradually, but it's really pigmented yet buildable. So yeah, and it wears really nicely. Yeah, Milani makes some really great blushes. Their Luminoso is a really popular one by Milani, but I don't really wear that one because it does have shimmer. But yeah, I've been loving that. It's a really beautiful matte pink. And then I've also been loving my Amazing Cosmetics Pink Chocolate. This is considered a matte blush, but it does almost have a bit of, a tiny bit of a sheen to it. Maybe just a tiny bit. Yeah, but not quite a sheen. Maybe like kind of a satin. I don't know. It's just beautiful, and it's the perfect everyday color. It's a beautiful light pinky nude. I think I talked about this last month, but it's just a beautiful blush. I got this last summer when I redeemed my Ulta points, and obviously I've been loving it because there's not a lot left. So yeah, absolutely love that as well. And then I've been loving my ColourPop blush in Between the Sheets. Yeah, that's just another really great everyday color, and if I use that, I'll apply it with my e.l.f. angled blush brush, which I meant to mention this as well actually, because I also used this today for the blush I put on, but which was Tarte Prim. But this is another brush that at first I was just kind of meh. But now I really like it. And it's $3 at Target. So if you need a good blush brush, just go to Target and get this one, because it's good. You could also use it as a highlight brush or contour or whatever. But it's a good brush. So, and it's really soft and washed well. So yeah, go get you one if you need a brush or angled brush or anything. And I've also been loving ColourPop Girly. It's just a beautiful I forget what they called it. It has like flecks of like pink and silver. I don't know if you'll be able to see that. My lights are probably too bright. Probably can't see it. But it's just beautiful. I like to use that on the inner corner and a bit on the lid. If I just want a little bit of highlight there. You can also use it as a cheek highlight. But yeah, it's just beautiful and it does last very well throughout the day as well. And then lastly, I just had a couple nail polishes. And they are all Sinful Colors, which I got mine for $1.99 each at Rite Aid. Because I just needed some more summer fun colors. I have a bunch of nail polishes back there, but most of them are like really old and don't go on the best. So I need to just go through those. But anyway, I've been really impressed by these and they wear pretty well. I can get like 4 or 5 days, which my nails still looking pretty good. So for $1.99, and they go on smooth and opaque in one coat. So on my fingers, I have Pink Forever and Hazard. And those are them right there. And they go on really nicely. And then on my toes right now, I have 24/7, which is just a bit of a brighter pink. So yeah, I just really loving those. And they're super affordable. Wear well. My Sephora Formula X polish wears like a little bit longer, but these aren't bad and they're super cheap, so yeah. Again, I got mine at Rite Aid, but I know they have Sinful Colors at like Target and a whole lot of places. So yeah, so that is it for my May favorites. I don't know if I'll have a June favorites up, hopefully by then I'll be able to kind of get back into videos, but by then I will have my little girl here, so yeah. That's crazy. So anyways, yeah, but that is it for today, and I will see you in my next video very soon. Bye guys.